Kentucky Blues. I'm a poor wayfaring stranger, wandering through this vale of woe. But there's no sickness, toll, or danger in that bright land to which I go. From Kentucky he came to East Chicago rail yard to work. He was gone. And at night, after 14-hour days, Gideon's Bible and the cheapest wine warmed body and soul. Sacred ceremony in ramshackle bedbug, newspaper walled, beer sign, neon hotel within eyeshot of the yard, not far to lumber on frigid morn. Early evening, through the night, all night, the wind whispers, cries, wails, sings to her. And through the cracks of her attic walls, she listens, listens. And when the window blows, she turns an ear to the voice coming to her through the stillness of gnarled cedar and pine, blanketing like shrouds the old gray-weathered wood-slatted farmhouse nestled deep in this cold, barren wilderness. And she turns an ear to the voice coming to her through the stillness of cedar and pine. And through the stillness, she turns and looks at his gray railman's hat hanging limp from eight-penny nail on wormwood wall. His hat and railroad manual were all he brought home the last time. But that first Christmas visit from East Chicago and his new job, he brought her a blue calico dress and red sweater with pearl buttons carried on the train with gifts for all. He and they all proud of him, a man, no longer boy, but always hard worker of farm and mine in this pioneer Kentucky land. But now he returns again, so soon, unexpected. Turns eternal presence home for good. His body from East Chicago rail yards he comes, his body crushed between coal cars, coal. And like the bituminous gold shipped from Kentucky to foreign parts, he's delivered by train. Long wailing whistle signals his arrival. Last stop of the L&N, and a year later, frail, tired, torn, she drifts through tears. By candlelight she sees his spirit at top of attic stairs, at foot of her bed, calming, real presence. He moves closer, reaching to her, his hand touches her forehead, her eyes close finally to deep dream sleep.